Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager. Unfortunately, last time we had a failed mission for our lunar flyby with the manned lunar flyby, and what was going wrong here? The Gemini trend stage has a failure, and so we have to research the thing again, and we can't relaunch the lunar flyby mission again. But can we do? Let me switch over to the next thing, the lunar orbital reconnaissance mission. What do we need here? We need the orbital flight. Yes, what things do we need for this? We don't need the trend stage, this is good. But we need here the propulsion module. Okay, this is bad because we haven't it. So what else? We need here the Venera 15 again. Is it currently up to date? Yes, 71%. I think it's good enough. Let me assemble it and start the launch process again. And auto assign the best candidates for this, because in the last episode we had a bad failure with this, a failure in the very last step of the 6-step mission, which was really sad and unfortunate. And so yes, let's relaunch this and let's follow it from the mission control. And we have again a proton rocket launch. So yes, I'm looking very forward to do even more flights with my Gemini program around the moon. But as I said last episode, at the end of last episode we had the failure with our trend stage, and now we need to re-improve this trend stage again after we had a successful unmanned flight around the moon, and we want to narrow see the moon with human eye from the far side. So we need to improve again our trend stage before we can move on and before we can schedule even more missions. And yes, the limiting factor right now are the amount of scientists I have, because I have only 25 scientists, and some are currently working on the Venus projects, and so I have only some scientists left for doing some work on the Gemini missions. And yes, that's the main problem. But I think we are on a good shape to reach a good status for our trend stage in the next season, so we are able to relaunch the lunar flyby with a manned capsule. And we have the first successful step of 6 for our Venera 15. Yes, Venera 15. And I hope this won't die in the last episode again, or in the last step again. Let me have here a look. No, not Earth again. Let me have here a look about our translunar stage. Where is it? Here. It's 65%. Okay, we need to wait another season. Let me just end the season. And what do we have here? Venera 15. The Saturn booster makes good progress. This thing here is hopefully also ready to go. Let's assign here our flight controllers again for the Venera 15 mission. And we want to follow it as it enters an orbit around the Venus, which is very important. I hope it's able to do so. Yes, a success. This is really good. And Venus orbit. Success. Okay. 2 of 6 steps are a success, that is good. I hope the other 4 steps will be a success as well. Let's see what happens now. Okay, this is good. And the Venera 15 goes on. This is also very good and very important. Now, I will risk the lives of my brave astronauts and schedule again a lunar flyby mission, and I hope that this time here our translunar stage is ready to go and will propel our astronauts into onto a trajectory towards the moon. So let's confirm our assignments and end the season, so we can make some good flights towards the moon and hopefully see the far side of the moon with our human eyes. Let's see what the Venera 15 does. Currently it's orbiting. And step 3 of 6, a success, that's good. We are making good progress. I'm proud of you. And now. Now it's the important moment. the first time that we will send humans onto a flight towards the moon. They won't land on the moon, but they will fly by the moon. This is the first time that we achieve this, and that we send humans into deep space, like around the moon, and it's the first time that they will see the far side of the moon with human eyes. Speaking of this maneuver, it's a little bit a free return trajectory. So the main idea behind this trajectory is that you're having a trajectory that goes to the moon, and because you're flying on the you're making a transfer around the moon on the opposite side as it's currently orbits, so the moon pulls the spacecraft towards it and slows it down a little bit, and by doing so it's it changes the trajectory of your spacecraft, and the spacecraft will automatically return back to Earth. This is also the kind of trajectory they used in the Apollo program, and it was also the good thing that rescued a little bit our the astronauts from Apollo 13, because they are on a flying on a free trajectory, or no, a free return trajectory, and this is meaning that they don't have to need or to do any burns around the moon or anything like this. The gravity of the moon will assist the spacecraft to return back to Earth if something went wrong, like in Apollo 13, and so they are able to fly back to the Earth without the need of doing a real retro fire burn or a real correction burn to return to Earth. Well, of course they have to do some correction burns to have a good re-entry into the Earth atmosphere, but the, you don't need to insert yourself at first into a stable lunar orbit before you can do a burn back to the Earth, or before you can insert yourself on the trajectory back to Earth. And this is the interesting thing about free return trajectories. What does it mean? Have I lost my astronauts? Aren't they able to return back to Earth? Or what is this meaning here? Well, the spacecraft was not... Are they not dead? Or what has happened? Help? What, the Gemini was also downgraded? Everything was downgraded? Holy crap. But they are just in orbit, they are not lost. And I think they should have some retrofire, so... yes, it failed, and have I lost my astronauts? I think he's still alive. Is he? Yes. What, I can do advanced training? No, I can't. That's just a menu. Okay. Okay. Not good. So I need to improve the Gemini spacecraft as well. This is bad. Pioneer Venus Multiprobe was a success. Do we have here some scientists? Yes, we have here some scientists working on it. But we won't to have them working on this mission because it was already finished. What else do we have here? Marina 5, are here some scientists working on the thing? No, I don't think so. No, okay. And Pioneer, is here someone working on the thing? No, that's good. And Venera 15 is important. Venera 7 aren't finished, so... Do we have here some scientists left on Luna 15? No, I don't have scientists left here. I don't think I have scientists here on Earth. I hope I don't have. Okay, I need to rebuild my Gemini capsule because it failed somehow. Okay, we can't do anything else, we can just end the season. and wait for the time that our spacecraft is good to go again and has received some important improvements. So let's go on with our Venera 15 mission, the fourth step of it. I hope it's still a success and we can finally finish this long-term mission. Okay, a success, well done. 4 of 6 are good. Okay, so well done, and the mission is still going on. I will just end the season so we can make some improvements. Okay, the Gemini capsule is looking good again, and all the other things is also looking good again. So let's assign here some flight controllers and confirm the assignments. Let's follow it, the fifth step of it. I hope it's still a success. Venus orbit and success. Okay, 5 of 6. Now in the next season, at the important moment that we hopefully have a success and we can finish this Venera 15 program. Okay, the thing is still going on, and I think it's time again for our next try to do the lunar flyby, because right now 73% and 79%, I think. Oh no, I will just end the season again and wait another round, so I hope that then I am really good to go and I can finally fly around the moon. Okay, resume that mission and follow it. And now, please, successful mission. Come on, come on, you can do this. Yes, success. Finally, we finished the Venera 15 missions. A long-term goal is finished, and now we have Genus Orbiter B, mapping of the surface level 1. Well done, everybody. Good job. Okay. So, now I think it's time for, where is it? The Venera 7. Can we need, yes, we want to Venera 7 start the assembly process. And now we have another Venus lander, this is really cool. And the other good thing is I can use my, where is Venera 15 here? You scientists are now finished with your job here, because we finished this mission. And this is meaning you can do other important things, like working on our moon landing thing, because we need here, where is it, the Gemini propulsion module. Yes. So you are now working on the Gemini propulsion module, so we can make more progress with the Gemini mission. And let me head back and end the season. So let's proceed. Venus lander. I want to see how we land on the Venus, and I hope we can also see how the thing is disintegrating. We have our proton rocket again. Okay, speaking of satellite launches, last week we had also the launch of some spy satellites with the Atlas V rocket from the Vandenberg Air Force Base, I guess it was. And it was also a successful launch in Europe. It was early morning. In US, where they launched it, it was around midnight, I guess. And it was a successful launch, unfortunately, because it is a spy satellite, and they won't see us where the spy satellite is placed. So they cut off the coverage of the mission and the insert of the into orbit just after the launch of the Atlas V rocket, so we can't see a lot of more information about this. Like during the Maven launch, there we had a lot of coverage until the Maven was placed until its trajectory towards Mars. And with this mission for the spy satellite, the coverage was finished just shortly after the launch, which was a little bit unfortunate. But on the other hand, if this is such an important mission and it's important that the spy satellite is a secret. Okay, now we have our lander entry. Interplanetary. And we are descending towards the surface. And now we are on the harsh surface. On the harsh surface of Venus. Well done, guys. Awesome. Okay, so we had also this launch. It was pretty interesting. GSA, Venus Lander, study of the surface of Venus. Well done, everybody. Well done. Good job. Okay, successful mission. So now I can also move some of the engineers here from the Venus Venera 7, the Venus Lander. You are dismissed from your mission. And now you can start working on, how is this called? Venera 9, yes. What do we need here? Here's only one guy working on it. So let's add some more scientists here. So we're making some good progress with the Venera 9. And we also have here the Venera 10 orbiter and lander. Oh, here already. What? Venera 9? Proton. What? Venera 11? Venera 9. Okay. I'm not getting it right now. We have here this. Anyway, we will see this in the near future. Now we have more important things to do, like our finally lunar flyby. I hope this time it's a success. Let's assemble it and proceed with this. So we have also our best candidates. And let's see if, oh, we have one scientist left, so we can assemble this assign the scientist to direct ascent. No, R12, where is it? Oh, we have here also. So this is meaning we can finally, where, come on, direct ascent. Yes, direct ascent, and we have some walking men on the ground. 14,000. Oh, that's a lot of money. What new things? Even though you have 18... Oh no, I don't want to schedule it. Wrong button again. The Saturn V booster. Oh, we have the Saturn V booster for the Gemini. This is interesting. And the direct ascent. So, you're a good human-rated rocket. This is good. So you can work here on the Saturn V booster, the most powerful rocket currently built and currently used. And here, I think this is a Saturn V launch platform. This is amazing. Oh no, or was it already for the other thing here? For our Titan booster? Maybe. So the Saturn V, what is this? The propulsion module, okay. And this thing is almost finished, and the we can proceed with the next Gemini mission after we were successful with our lunar flyby. So hopefully we will have this time a successful lunar flyby. Yes, I guess the Titan 3 booster already uses the third launch platform we have seen in the background of our space complex. Okay, Saturn V, yes, it was the most powerful rocket ever built currently, but there have also some other powerful rockets. How was it called? The Russians had a similar, almost similar rocket to the Saturn V booster, which was also used for their lunar program, but it was never successful as the Saturn V booster. They had all the time problems with it, and it's all the time disintegrated and has problems, so it was never a successful launch, but it was even powerful. And there are some next generation rockets planned, which will have more more power and more capability of launching things into Earth orbit or even into geostationary orbit. But currently I think the Saturn V booster is still the most powerful rocket ever built, and it was used only for the Apollo missions, and the last time the Saturn V booster was used was for the Skylab launch, which was only a partial success. Well, they brought the Skylab into orbit and into they brought it into orbit, but during the launch of the Saturn V booster with the Skylab, there went something wrong, and the was damaged. I guess the something about the solar panel or something was damaged and they had some trouble with the heating of the Skylab, so the whole thing has no... the cooling techniques for the Skylab were damaged and they had no option to cool the thing down, so they couldn't send astronauts right away up to the space station, and they have to sort of think about solutions how they can salvage the space station, how they can repair it, and they did it. And so yes, the Skylab had to be repaired after its launch because it was damaged during its first launch into space, and they had to make some improvements to this. And because the thing was so damn heated up, they had also some problems with poisonous gases or so in the station, and they had to vent the station. And so yes, there were a lot of trouble with the Skylab, but in the end Skylab was still a success, and we had three missions up there, and the Skylab missions were all a success. And well, we had some long duration stays up there from three missions, and the astronauts had also a shower up there and did a lot of spacewalks, and they I think around Skylab it was also the first time that the that an EVA was used to repair something in space. So yes, it was a 9000 prestige. Awesome. So yes, it was the very first time that a spacewalk and circumlunar reconnaissance mission. Yes, we have seen the back or the far side of the moon with human eyes. This is amazing. I am proud of all of you. And the maximum R&D level of what? Okay, so let's prepare even more. We have here our direct ascent. We need to improve here our Saturn V booster. Let's assign here some scientists, and also assign a scientist here to the Gemini direct ascent. And we can continue with our lunar orbital reconnaissance mission. Let's start with a uncrewed orbital test flight. Let's schedule this mission and start the assembly process. We have our, again, just a test flight with the Gemini rocket. This is okay. I think we are good to go. And do we have something else here with our Venus, our Venera 7? No, Venera 7 was a success. Was it? Oh dear. Where do I see this again? One step back. Yes, that was a success. We finished this. So the next thing is here, Venera 9, even if I don't understand this. This thing needs some improvements. Okay. So we can just go back to Space Complex and launch our Gemini mission again. So the Venera 9 makes some progress, this is awesome. And the Saturn V booster makes also some progress. And here we have our landing stage. Okay, let's launch that mission, and we want to follow it from the mission control as usual. So here we go. Oh, they have here... because the thing is so small and they have the huge tower, they have had to build this chair or this little ramp to place the rocket even higher a bit. We are going into space. Well done. With our Saturn booster. The first flight of our Saturn booster. This is amazing. Here it goes. And here goes our capsule. And we have inserted ourselves into an orbit. A successful insertion. Well done, guys, well done. And we are orbiting? Are we orbiting? Yes, we are orbiting. So yes, Skylab, Saturn V booster, most powerful rocket, amazing, just amazing. And yes, now they are working on maybe similar or more powerful rockets for the upcoming missions with the Orion spacecraft. I'm really looking forward to the Orion project. Speaking of Orion, Orion, the Orion spacecraft, sorry. The Orion spacecraft, this week they delivered the heat shield for the Orion spacecraft. It was my tongue is or somehow mixed up or whatever. So they've delivered the heat shield for the Orion spacecraft, and NASA called it the early Christmas gift because, well, they have now the heat shield for the Orion spacecraft, yes. And we have now some more free scientists. This is very good because now we can continue making progress with our direct ascent. We want to R&D something. Here we want to the Gemini direct ascent. Let's R&D the thing. And do we have here something else? Saturn V booster. Here. Do we need here something? We don't need to R&D the spacesuits. Interesting. Why do we need to R&D the spacesuit? We have here, they have also the EVA suits and no one has to design them. Okay, interesting. So, Gemini, orbital flight, yes. Let's put our fair and brave astronauts into danger with our first manned space flight with this configuration. Let's end the season. Oh, there's one scientist unemployed. Where can I employ him? Venus probes, maybe? So, R&D. Venera 9. I think there's something terrible wrong with this, because here I have the Venera... I see this one, but I can't R&D it. If I click on R&D, I see all the time Venera 9. This is confusing me, but, well... But what happened if I... where do we have the thing? Here, Venera, Venus, flyby and lander. What if I schedule this? Assemble it. Start assembly process. It uses the Venera 9 probe, okay. Yes, I want to cancel this, because it's not ready right now. Gemini, yes, of course. I have one scientist unemployed. Maybe we open... No, we don't. We have to manage some programs at first. I will finish the Marina 5, because it's finished, yes. So, no, not Jupiter, but Mars. The Marina 6, yes, let me open up this program. And what do we need for the Marina 6? The Atlas Agena boost, oh, pretty old. And the and our Marina 6. Let's add here Janice Meinecker, and she will research the thing. And we end the season and have our manned Gemini flight. So let's launch this mission. And we will enjoy the whole and great and amazing coverage of the improved or improvised launch platform here with the extra tower. Here is our Gemini mission. And here we go. We are flying and heading towards space. A successful launch into space with ascent. Was I talking or rambling around a certain topic? I spoke about the latest Atlas launch, I spoke about the powerful Saturn V, I spoke about Skylab. I can just remind you on the thing that I like you to ask me some questions or leave me comments in the YouTube section. So I started in the last episode as Sweet Wolf has asked me a question where I'm coming from and where are my origins. I answered this question and I encourage you to send me some new questions I can answer. One thing you have to keep in mind, I'm currently recording 3 episodes on one weekend, and so if I upload the episodes over the week and release them over the week, and if you are now listening to this or watching this video, it's currently Thursday, I guess, and the next videos I will record are on Saturday or so. So, if you're now asking question, or if you have asked question a question in the last episode, I'm not have answered it right now, because I will answer them in the next weekend. So you can look for newer answers in the next. No, not in the next, but in the. What are we now? We are now at 19, I guess. We are currently episode 19, so not in the 20s episode, but in the episode 21. Yes, in episode 21, if you have left any question about myself, you can see the answers possibly in episode 21, if I have counted correctly. And about counting correctly, I'm counting also the minutes of this episode, and this is the end of the episode. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. If you do so, please like this video on YouTube, please become a subscriber to my YouTube channel, and also please leave me a question or a comment in the YouTube comment section. And I hope you will watch also the next episode when we continue with our Gemini project. Until then, my name is Sebi. See you!